Now, it is a rare condition that affects the production of melanin, and generally people who are born albino have very pale skin, virtually white hair, and severe problems with their sight.
They can also come up against prejudice, and now a young woman from Yorkshire is challenging those perceptions.
Tasmin Cressoti, who was bullied throughout her life for being albino, is urging other young people to embrace what makes them different and to be proud.
She's enlisted the help of Fixers, that's the ITV campaign that gives young people a voice to say, love yourself. Tasmin has carved out a career as a model, and as such, this report does contain some flash photography.
Growing up, I was always made to feel different because I'm so pale. I've had food thrown over me, I've had stones thrown at me, people calling me a freak and people just shouting albino at me. It completely ruined my self-confidence, my self-esteem. I really let it affect me. But now, I love being really pale. And my image is built around that as opposed to it being something that I want to hide. I'm Tasmin Cressoti, I'm 20 and I'm from Whitby. I'm working with Fixers to challenge the stigma around albinism and encourage people to embrace what's different about them.
That's two pictures.
I was born with albinism. It's a condition that means my eyesight's quite poor and I've got very little pigment in my skin, hair and eyes.
First time I got a really nasty comment was when this old couple came over and looked in the pram, as people do, and they recoiled, and do you know what they said?
What?
That babies like that shouldn't be brought out, they should be locked away at home. And that is the only time I've went home and cried my eyes out.
I live in Whitby. You can't really walk down the street without seeing any goths. And this was a massive influence on me. There's a group of people here who are like, don't let me in the sun, I want to be pale. And that was really nice because I fitted in somewhere. The more that I did it, the less I got bullied. The big turning point for me was alternative model contest. When I actually won it, I was... Obviously, at first it was like shock. It's like, me? What?
Great shot.
It was just the biggest thing that could have happened to my confidence was winning that, and it just completely changed how I felt about myself. I wouldn't have won it if I was everything that people said I was. Loads of the people who were bullying me were then coming up to me and saying really complimentary things.
Yeah,
like, really, you look amazing. Oh, I've seen your pictures. They look great. It's a bit of a turning point from 2 years ago when you were calling me a freak.
You just don't need the computer at all, do you?
No airbrushing required.
The message I'd like to get across to other people really is just embrace who you are, embrace being different. People's opinions aren't always right, and you should just love who you are, even if you've got something about you that does make you different.
There are lots of different types of albinism. The one that we see traditionally with the white hair is oculocutaneous albinism, and there's between 3,000 and 4,000 people in the UK roughly with that condition. Tasmin's message is absolutely spot on. It's about giving people that are visually distinctive the confidence to stand up and say, this is what I am, and that's great.
And remember, I used to say to you so many times, your day will come, you'll have your chance to shine in the sun.
Yeah, no, you did. Like, I didn't believe you, but you did, yeah.
But did it come true?
No, it did, yeah, you were right.
Mums are always right.
It is the most wonderful feeling to think that I can help people to be proud of themselves, to like how they look. Hopefully, maybe other people can say, actually, if she can overcome it, I can overcome it as well.
Tasmin Cressoti. And to see more about her story and the work of Fixers, or to find out to help on this issue, visit Fixers at fixers.org.uk/albinism.